mission. Hide my head, I wanna drown my sorrow. No tomorrow, no tomorrow. And I find it kinda funny, I find it kinda sad. The dreams in which I'm dying are the best I've ever had. I find it hard to tell you, I find it hard to take. When people run in circles, it's a very, very mad world. Mad world. Children waiting for the day they feel good. Happy birthday, happy birthday. And I feel the way that every child should. Sit and listen, sit and listen. Went to school and I was very nervous. No one knew me, no one knew me. Hello teacher, tell me what's my lesson. Look right through me, look right through me. I'm dying are the best I've ever had. I find it hard to tell you, I find it hard to take. People run in circles, it's
no way.
A very, very
we're partners, remember we had a deal.
Listen, Lauren, I know you want to find the killer, but you're not helping me by putting yourself in danger.
I'm not a child. I know what I have to do. I want to find my sense killer. You're not going to stop me.
Your son is dead, Lauren. Getting yourself killed is not going to bring him back to life.
Stop the car. Stop the fucking car!
It's all my fault. I should never have let her come with me.
This girl's stubborn as a mule. She doesn't let up, with or without me.
Lauren!
I miss him. I miss him so much. I'd do anything to hold him once again in my arms.
What do you want? Oh, fuck it. I said 1,000 times that I don't want any junkies at my door. If you you want to score, man, you gotta fucking call first. Come on. Beat it. Fuck! Are you deaf or what? I should get out of here! You're gonna cause me trouble, and I... Hey! Take it easy, man, huh? Keep cool. What do you want? Dope? Money? Tell me what you need. I'm sure we can make a deal, huh? God! I'm gonna blow your brains out, you son of a bitch! Hold it, man. I give you whatever you want. Got dope? Got cash? You want some dope? Please. Please don't kill me, man. I got children. These are my girls, see? This one's Sarah. And a little one. That's Cindy. Please, man. I want to see them again. Please, please don't shoot.
I'm a father too, but I have no choice.
It's Sam. I got your information. And the owner of the apartment in Marble Street is a Dr. Adrian Baker. He's a struck-off surgeon. They used to sell drugs to junkies on the quad. He made some cash and bought up some cheap-ass apartments, including the one in Marble Street. Of course, he got caught. He did a few months in prison and was struck off the medical register.
Interesting. Thanks for the information, Sam. I owe you one.
Hey, Matt, be careful, okay?
I'm on it. Talk to you later. The owner of the apartment where Ethan cut off his finger lives here. It's not much of a lead, but it's all I've got. Hi. I was told that you could get Bitropin. Without a prescription.
Sorry, you were misinformed. Goodbye.
Hold on. I really need your help here. I can pay.
Well, why didn't you say so? Please, come in. So, you're looking for Bitropin, my dear. Are you having trouble sleeping? How much do you need?
I don't know, about 3-4 boxes.
Well, no, that shouldn't be a problem. Would you like a drink? I was just about to have one.
Sure, why not?
I haven't seen you around here before. Who told you about me?
I met a guy at a party. He popped some Bitropin. Told me he got it from you. Do you have many clients?
A few. I help to ease their anxiety. Are my hands been off, thin enough, hardworking enough? I reassure those who find the system too difficult. I'm like a safety valve that keeps society from imploding.
I heard you had some apartments for rent. I'm looking.
Sorry, darling. Those are all booked up.
Shame. I was looking for something around Marble Street.
You're not drinking?
I'm not really thirsty.
I'll get your prescription. It won't be a moment. Wait here.
That guy gives me the creeps. I better take a look around to see if I can find anything before he gets back. Could the doc be the origami killer? There's something about the way he looks. Surgical gowns? I thought he stopped performing operations. Must be some kind of a weird nostalgia for the past. Don't make a sound. He's near.
Huh?
gotta find something.
Some fun together, my darling. I promise. Ah. Say hello to Matthew. He claimed he had come to the census. Another one of those goddamn government spies. So, you're interested in my Marble Street apartment. I rent it to my friend Paco, if you must know. I have no idea what he does there. Maybe that's where he fornicates with his dancers from the Blue Lagoon. To be honest, I don't give a damn. Just as long as he pays his rent, he can do whatever he likes. But enough with the chit-chat. I miss surgery, you see, so I take every opportunity to practice. I don't have any instruments here, so I use whatever comes to hand. I hope you won't hold that against me. Hold on. This might sting him. Have you ever noticed? As soon as you start to do a little housework, someone always comes calling. I'll get rid of our visitor and be right back. Don't move. I won't be long.
Oh my God! He's gonna cut me up!
Hello, sir. I come to bring the word of the Lord in the form of his magnificent Bible. I would gladly be with you. In return for contribution of only $5.
No thanks, I love it.
Ha 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 Can you stop that thing? Norman Jaden, FBI. Can we talk for a minute?
I'm listening.
Can we go inside? I've got less than 24 hours if I want to find Sean Morris still alive. Two butchers came. Got it in my pocket. Blake wasn't in the office when I left. Don't think I'm gonna miss him. I'm looking for the owner of a blue Chevrolet Malibu 83. I don't give a damn how the car got here, or whether you stole it or not. I just want to know who bought it from you.
Sorry, man. Don't ring a bell. I got a real bad memory of a name.
Perhaps I can help you to remember. If we find out that you sold the car to the man we're looking for, you're looking at some pretty solid time inside, Jackie boy.
You trying to scare me with your big talk? I never saw your damn car. Now take a walk.
Fingerprints. Probably Matt Jack's. Traces of blue paint. Gary, comment. Traces of orchid pollen in the air inside the garage. Same tire tracks, traces of blue paint. Killer's car definitely came through here. Not the car I'm looking for. Size 13. Must be Matt Jack's size. Size 10. Most likely a visitor. Blood. Now why is there blood here? Not the right car either. Not much help, this so-called Mad Jack. He's either clean as a whistle, or else he's got something to hide. The blood tracks lead to the acid bath.
One of your cop buddies asking too many questions. I had to solder up his little mouth. Hands on your head, pig. I ain't got time to be playing around with you. Let's just get you out of sight and finish you off.
Around. You're gonna tell me about the man with the blue car.
Go fuck yourself in the ass.
I've no time to lose, Jack. I wanna know who that car belongs to.
What you want don't mean shit to me. I ain't no snitch. You better just lock me up now, boy.
Last chance, Jack. Make it easy on yourself.
What you gonna do? You ain't got them killer eyes, so what? You gonna cuff me? Broke my fucking nose, pig!
Next, I'm gonna blow a hole in your face. Spill all of it.
You don't scare me, Mr. CSI. You ain't got it in you.
Do you like fireworks, Jack? Cause I bet them gas tanks are gonna blow up real nice.
Shit, man, don't mess with the gasoline.
Well, just say it was an accident. Or rather, I'll say it was an accident cause you won't really be able to talk, will you, Jack?
You crazy motherfucker, you out of your mind, man? No, I don't know nothing about the guy. He wanted me to get rid of his dirty car, get him a new one with false plates. He paid cash, and I ain't the questioning kind. Said I was supposed to drop the word to a guy named Paco down at the Blue Lagoon when the car was done. Now that's all I know.
We'll continue this discussion down at the station. You're under arrest. You have the right to remain silent. Anything... Shit, not now. Anything you say can and will be...
Hey, you look like you got a problem, man.
Turn around.
So you think the origami killer killed Manfred?
That makes sense. Didn't want him spilling his guts to us.
And you suspect Gordy Kramer, right?
Oh, him or one of his men. Gordy has the time and the means, not to mention the fucked up attitude to go along with it. He's only a suspect, but he's a pretty guilty looking one.
Are these your files on the case?
Yeah, I've been working on them for a couple years. I built up a mountain of paperwork.
Magazines about origami? You think the killer could have subscribed to one of those?
If he was even remotely interested in origami in the last 30 years, his name may be in there somewhere. Trouble is, there's over 500 names. It gets a squat.
I'm starving. Do you have anything to eat?
Well, I'm no chef, but I should be able to make some scrambled eggs if you like.
Great. I'm soaking wet. I need to warm up a little. Is it okay if I take a shower?
I'll be my guest. Go to my bedroom. It's the next door. Oh, I'll cook up the eggs while you're under the shower.
Eggs should be ready by now.
I took the liberty of borrowing your bathrobe.
Looks better on you.
Hey, that almost looks good enough to eat.
What's that?
The notebook I took from Manfred's place. According to this, about 30 clients bought spare parts for Royal Machines in the last 10 years. The killer may be one of them.
Oh, you know, checking out the alibi of 30 clients, one by one, that's a lot of legwork.
Except that if we cross-check them with the list of subscribers to Origami magazines, you still got that, right?
Yeah, of course. But Lauren, wait.
If the killer really used a Royal typewriter, and if he subscribed to an Origami magazine, his name should be on both lists.
Well, Lauren, I mean, that's just an assumption, but yeah, I suppose.
His name is here somewhere. Help me, we're gonna find him.
Thank you.
only guy whose name was on both lists died when he was 10. What are you gonna do now? Dig up his coffin, make sure he's dead?
I know it doesn't make any sense. Unless the killer was only using his name.
But why use the name of a kid who died 30 years ago?
Well, that's what we came to find out. The name is John Shepherd. It should be on a grave around here somewhere.
You never give up, do you? Excuse me, I'm looking for... Well, don't worry about it. I can manage alone.
Excuse me. I'm looking for the grave of a young boy who died about 30 years ago. His name was John Shepherd. You wouldn't know where it is by any chance.
The children's graves are in the next plot.
Thanks.
Excuse me. I'm looking for the grave of a boy named John Shepherd.
Straight ahead, a little further out.
Thanks. Hey, Lauren. I found it.
Origami figures.
That's one hell of a coincidence.
These flowers are fresh. Looks like someone's still tending the grave.
Oh, youngin'. That one I knew well.
You knew John Shepherd?
I've worked this graveyard nearly all my life. I remember what happened. It was in 77, October, I think.
Yeah, good for no good, man. Come back when your fucking mother comes home from work.
He's drunk again.
What are we gonna do? It's pouring rain. We're gonna get soaked if we spend a day outside.
Well, at least you won't get beat. Little rain never hurt nobody. Come on, let's go play.
Bet you can't catch me!
nothing but a slowpoke. Bet you can't do that. Jeez, you're in nothing but a slowpoke. Come on, loser! What you doing? You're coming or not? You don't need to do this. It's too hard for you.
No chance. I can do it all right. Just watch. John, wait for me!
Get a move on! Let's play hide and seek. You go and count to 20 and try to find me, okay?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 10, 14, 18, 20.
My foot is stuck.
Grab on! I'll throw it there!
poor kid never did find any help. And his brother drowned in a pipeful of rainwater.
The boy that lived, what happened to him?
Well, all I know is he got separated from his parents. I think he got adopted. Well, looks like a storm's coming. I guess I better be getting home.
Christ, what a horrible story. John Shepherd drowned in the rain while holding his brother's hand. Do you think he could be the origami killer?
Come on, let's get back in the car.
What's the matter?
That man over there.
Yeah?
It's Charles Kramer.
Gordy's father? What's he doing here?
He's putting flowers on John Shepherd's grave.
Just a perfect day. Drink sangria in the park. And then later, when it gets dark, we go home. Just a perfect day. Feed animals in the zoo. Then later, a movie too, and then home. Oh, it's such a perfect day. I'm glad I spent it with you. Oh, such a perfect day. You just keep me hanging on. You just keep. Just a perfect day. Problems all left alone. Weekenders on our own. It's such fun. Just a perfect day. You made me forget myself. I thought I was someone else, someone good.